Welcome, everyone, to an incredible event tonight featuring many of the world's greatest athletes. The United States with a very talented team taking on the Australian team full of talent themselves, all on this international stage. We'll see Australia and Team USA.
And what a...
And nothing...
Well, guys, a lot of heads were turned when Prez was named to the Team USA roster. Most figured he would just warm the bench and gain valuable experience before his rookie season. But he's impressed during the camps, and he could be on his way to securing minutes during the tournament. Back to you.
Thank you, David. And the experience Prez Gregg is getting on this team is invaluable.
And getting a chance to learn and practice, Kevin, with the elite of the game, the fact that he might see the floor is just icing on the cake.
So Australia will get a platoon swap here for Team USA. Australia trails by 10.
And this tournament has shown the world just how far Australian basketball has come. A lot of great players on this team, and almost all of them playing for NBA teams.
Well, over the past few decades, basketball has really exploded in Australia. And they're seeing what could be the start of a golden era for their national team.
1:53 left in the first quarter of the game. Shots good by Baines.
Aaron Baines is powerfully built, 6'10", about 260 pounds. He's clearly a banger. When he sets a screen on you, you better bite hard on that mouth guard. Otherwise, you might lose your chiclets.
Agreed. Prez kicks to Lowry. Lead pass was put in just the right spot.
And just amazing awareness there. Prez whipping the ball all over quickly to the uncovered man.
Anderson outside. Here's Baines, guarded by Jordan.
Serving up justice. Good play, man.
Team USA leading by 10. Lowry kicks to Prez. The three. And Baines pulls it down.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin.
Pretty clear. They're dominating that area. They've come out with a lot more energy and effort so far.
Delavidova dishes to Baines. Pulls it up. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron.
And on the international stage like this, it is always amazing to see the best and brightest of the United States come together. So many teams represented here today.
And the saying is country before club. And as much as all these stars like to battle it out in the NBA, they all have one goal when playing in the red, white, and blue. An incredible collection of talent for sure, and one mission in mind, win it.
And it's good. Assisting on the play was Delavidova. Baines has got 6 points.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
Prez, no good. With one on the clock. The shot off that time. And welcome back, everyone. International basketball at its finest. Already one quarter in the books. USA versus Australia. A lot of talent on both of these teams.
And guys, this USA squad looked pumped and really ready to go. They've got to be feeling pretty good about how they've been playing.
No doubt about that. But this Australian team is extremely talented, and there's plenty of time left. So it'll be interesting to see how the Boomers execute here in the second quarter.
And what can you say about the impact Coach K has had on USA basketball? Has led the team to victories in every major tournament. More importantly, though, has brought the prestige back to the program. The best of the best in the U.S. once again line up to be a part of the national team.
Australia making a switch here. Down low. Outside, Martin. Brokaw. It's hauled in by Team USA. And with Coach K, that is what I think people forget. USA Basketball was underachieving in tournaments before he took over in 2006.
Yeah, exactly, Kevin. I mean, Coach K was the perfect guy to ignite a real passion for players to get excited about representing their country again. I mean, had the gravitas with all the pros because of his legendary status as a college coach, knows how to manage people and players and these stars. And he's had them playing unselfishly and as a unit his entire tenure. Credit to Coach K for sure, but also to the players as well.
Well, when the U.S. picks players from the NBA, it just isn't about taking the best player at each position. They look at much more than that to assemble the best team that they can.
Yeah, and that's a great point because this is not an all-star team, although many of these players are all-stars. There's a difference. Really, they're looking for players that can impact the game without the ball, make others around them better, and are suited for the international style of play.
Here's Martin, gets the 14-footer to fall. Quarter number two, we're about 2 minutes in. Irving kicks to Prez. Some nice ball movement by Team USA. Irving passes to Prez. Jordan the screen. Prez dishes to DeRozan. And here's Anthony from the arc. And again, Team USA, no luck. Australia trails by 11. Martin goes in and stolen by Jordan. And Prez with a clear path to the hoop. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Prez has got four this quarter. Well, it's been a bit of a tradition to take one exceptional college player on the U.S. team and on their roster. This cycle, it's Prez's turn.
And it's happened before. Remember Christian Laettner and the Brow and just how those two were special in college. The same can be said for Prez. Plus, he'll get a chance to test himself on the international stage.
And for those of you just joining us, we're in the second quarter with about 3 minutes gone by. Count that one.
And what an honor it has to be for Prez to be representing his country on perhaps one of the biggest stages of basketball. Prez showed what he's capable of in college, and with his skill set, it wasn't too surprising to see him named to the team. Overall, it's been an incredible learning experience for Prez.
Martin with the bucket. Team USA leading by 11. Here's Irving. That's in, and that's his fourth basket of the night. He's taken seven shots, a solid 57%.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Well, the defensive rotations, Greg, have been a step slow, and it's really helped them get that ball inside time after time.
There's the screen. The dish to Martin. Plenty of space. Offensive rebound. The second chance effort, and the bank shot is good. Martin's got six.
And you have to be impressed with the balance that the Australian team has. Defenders and scorers from top to bottom. It's a big part of why they have been so successful here in the tournament.
Yep, exactly. I mean, the Australians have put together a team that works extremely well with each other and have played unselfish basketball the whole way. I mean, they're definitely more than the sum of their parts on paper. And I'd say kudos to the Australian Federation for putting this group together.
And DeRozan kicks to Prez. Outside Irving. Just five to shoot. And Team USA getting another basket right there.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of them.
Now Martin. He has six. DeRozan defending. It'll go, and the Team USA lead is cut down now to just nine in the bucket from Baines.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Prez passes to DeRozan. They set the pick out to the right wing. Here's Prez. That shot off. Australia goes the other way with it. We've got 28 seconds left in the first half. P. Pass to Martin. The 15-footer. And that's collected by DeAndre Jordan. Irving kicks to Prez. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. Irving's got three assists now in this one.
And this is what happens when you don't crack.
That'll do it for the first half. Team USA leading by 12. We'll see you after halftime. A different look now for Team USA. Paul George comes in for DeMarcus Cousins. And Prez is subbed in for Durant. Australia also with a sub. Anderson, he's checked in for Andrew Bogut.
And perhaps the biggest strength of this Australian team, their passing ability. Everyone at every position has a great sense of how to move the ball around.
Yeah, when you have guys like Bogut, Ingles, who all have size and can keep the ball moving around when it's not in the hands of a guard, I mean, that's a fun, enjoyable.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got the USA and Australia teams on the floor and ready to get going here for quarter number four. Nobody near Irving. No good on the triple.
You know, 9 times out of 10, he's going to knock that one down. He'll spray that one on you.
And there's the feed to Exum. And the pass to Mills. Lets it go from deep. It's hauled in by Team USA. Irving dishes to Prez. That one falls. Prez has got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for Team USA. Here's Australia. And Mills kicks to Exum. Brokoff. And that comes off the assist by Exum.
What is amazing to me about this U.S. team is that on every NBA team, all these players are the guy. Yet here for the U.S. team, each player has no qualms or hesitation to put their egos aside and play a minor role if needed.
Well, you know all of these guys, Greg, are great competitors, and they know that they'll see the ball a lot less being part of this team, but it's part and parcel of the sacrifice they sign up for when they have the honor of representing the United States in international competition. You know, the teardrop sometimes is one of those, oh no, oh no, oh yeah, shots.
And George kicks to Prez. No good on the three.
And even without that three ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
Defended by George. Feeds to Mills. 50. Fires for three. No good on that one. Some solid defense there from Irving. Green, the pass to George. And he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in.
And just a little bit ragged defensively.
Yeah, it's so bad I would even go a step farther and call it raggedy. I mean, that's how their defense has been overall today.
Well, for many, the fact that Australia even made it to the finals of this tournament is an accomplishment on its own.
Yeah, I agree with you wholeheartedly there, Greg, no matter what.
So it's Team USA winning this one easily. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team by far tonight.
And you got to commend this sort of dominance, particularly here at home. It's a great feeling.
Good evening and welcome to the NBA Draft. Boston Celtics select Jaylen Brown from the University of California, Berkeley. With the fourth pick in the NBA draft, the Phoenix Suns select Dragan Bender from Croatia. With the fifth pick in the NBA draft, the Minnesota Timberwolves select Chris Dunn from Hopkins College. With the sixth pick in the NBA draft, New Orleans Pelicans select Buddy Hield from Freeport, Bahamas and the University of Oklahoma. With the seventh pick in the NBA draft, the Denver Nuggets select Jamal Murray from Kitchener, Canada and the University of Kentucky. With the eighth pick in the NBA draft, the Sacramento Kings select Marquise Chris from the University of Washington. With the ninth pick in the NBA draft, the Toronto Raptors select Jakob Poeltl from the University of Utah. With the 10th pick in the NBA draft, the Milwaukee Bucks select Thon Maker from South Sudan and Perth, Australia. With the 11th pick in the NBA draft, the Orlando Magic select Domantas Sabonis from Kaunas, Lithuania and Gonzaga University. With the 12th pick in the NBA draft, the Utah Jazz select Torian Prince from Baylor University. With the 13th pick in the NBA draft, the Phoenix Suns select Yorgos Papayannis from Megara, Greece. With the 14th pick in the NBA draft, the Chicago Bulls select Denzel Valentine. With the 15th pick in the NBA draft, the Denver Nuggets select the 19-year-old small forward from Georgetown University.
Welcome to the NBA, gentlemen.
Can't believe we made it, man.
Yup.
All right, so practice tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. I'm just joking. Enjoy the offseason. But get ready to hit it hard in the fall.
We will be.
Yo, Prez, we got a jet.
Okay.
Things to do.
Who's this to you guys? Oh, that's my agent. Just talking to some shoe companies.
Already?
Yep.
Good stuff, man.
Thanks.
Crushed it.
I appreciate it.
When you're hot, you're hot, right?
We'll hit the gym.
All right. All right. So this is our trainer and your trainer, Xavier Cross.
Mr. Cross, it's nice to meet you.
Can't wait to work with you.
Xavier really is the best, and it's his job to make sure that you're healthy through the whole season, so
cool.
Do not be shy about reaching out to him.
Yeah. 100%. Anything doesn't feel right or you feel off, just call me. Don't be a tough guy about these things.
Even if I'm sick, have the flu, something
anything, like that? Anything. How do you think Michael Jordan got through his flu game? The trainers were right there.
Yeah. See, we got everything covered. So all you need to worry about is putting the ball in the hoop.
Well, that's what I do.
All right, good. All right, we got more stuff to check
out. All right, see you soon.
I'm going to be back because I've got this, you know, the tweak thing I did to my neck?
Yeah, it's chronic. We'll take care of that.
It's chronic. That sounds good. All right, let's go. It's fine.
Medical term.
It'll be fine.
See you, coach.
Anybody wants a piece?
Guess the crown is heavy.
Anyway, appreciate it, guys. I'll see you soon. Whew. Didn't know I was signing up for an entourage when I got drafted. I mean, it's annoying, right?
I mean, I wouldn't know, Mr. President. All right, see you around next.
All right, buddy.
I mean, I can't shake these reporters.
Don't worry about that. Keep an eye on your teammates. Those are the guys that'll hold you up.
Hope so.
I know so.
All right, man.
Oh, there he is. There he is.
What's up, man?
What's up, man? Denver, I just got picked up.
Denver, oh, what's up? I heard you were coming through. Nice to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you, man. Everybody knows you, man. Prez, President.
Prez, yeah. Even you know the nickname, huh?
It's a catchy name.
I guess so. So, yeah. Where you from?
Seattle.
Denver from?
Yes, Seattle. From Seattle. Good one. Like, everyone has said that one already.
Okay, so first time I met you.
That's what you. What system you play on?
What system?
Mm-hmm.
Any system you want to get beat on. That's the system I play on.
Okay, Prez. Listen, bro. This right here, this is you right now. I can see it. This is all you. But 2K, any system, that's Denver.